Chancellor, welcome back to the Oval Office. Welcome back to the White House. Olaf, we've been a lot changed since the last year you were here. Matter of fact, if I'm not mistaken, you were here in February of 2022, and Russia was amassing its troops, 185,000 troops on the Ukrainian border. And we made it clear that if he moved, we would both respond. And together we made good in that promise. And I want to thank you, Olaf, for your strong and steady leadership. I mean that sincerely. It's made a world of difference. And together, we made good on our promise. You stepped up to provide critical military support. And, you know, I would argue that beyond your military support, the moral support you gave to the Ukrainians has been profound. It's been profound. And you've driven historic changes at home and, increasing defense spending and diversifying away from Russian energy sources. I know that's not been easy, very difficult for you. Together, we worked lockstep to supply critical security assistance to Ukraine. And from everything from we've done it in lockstep, ammunition, artillery, armored tanks, air defense systems, and we've been together throughout this. You help Ukraine meet its basic needs like food, health, heating, and you continue to give them maintain the pressure on Putin, and it is undercutting his ability to fight this war. And as NATO allies, we're making the alliance stronger and more capable. You've heard me say before that when I talked to Putin a couple months before that, I told him that we're more likely to get the NATOization, Finlandization of Europe, which he was pushing for, more like you get the NATOization of Europe. And he's had that effect in terms of what's happened. So a lot's happened since last year. We got a lot to talk about, and I look forward to our conversation.
Thank you for having me again, and I really appreciate to be back at the White House. And let me just say, this is a very, very important year because of the very dangerous threat to peace that comes from Russia invading Ukraine. And it's really important that we acted it together, that we organized our lockstep, and that we made it feasible that we can give the necessary support to Ukraine during all this time. And at this time, I think it is very important that we give the message that we will continue to do so as long as it takes and as long as it is necessary, and that we are ready also for staying with the Ukrainians as long as it is necessary. And I really appreciate the very good cooperation between the two of us, our governments, and the United States, Germany, and Europe. And the transatlantic partnership is really in a very good shape today, and this is very much thanks to your leadership. So I'm really happy to be here to talk with you.
I'm glad to talk about it. Thank you.